the most important thing in the future is not hardware anymore. It's
Apple Intelligence.
Apple Intelligence.
Apple Intelligence.
Yes, Apple Intelligence is the company's AI system that will be integrated throughout its iPhone, Mac, and iPad operating systems.
We had about a week to embrace all the new things that Apple has brought us, and I think this is one of the biggest steps Apple has ever made in terms of improving their own hardware and software. So let's react after a week to Apple Intelligence. If you don't know what Apple Intelligence is, I'll summarize it for you very, very quickly. Apple Intelligence is Apple's new AI system that is going to be built in to your iPhone, iPad, and Mac that will do all the calculations and all the processes on device. It's artificial intelligence, which Apple is calling Apple Intelligence, and all of the processes will be happening on your device. Whatever cannot happen on your device is going to go out to a private cloud compute, which is Apple's own servers, and not the full question, not the full task is going out, only some small parts of those are going out to the cloud. And for generative things, Apple has connected their own operating system to ChatGPT. So if you want to generate pictures, generate text, then ChatGPT will be doing that for you. If you've spent the last week on YouTube, I'm pretty sure you've heard of Apple Intelligence, and I think it is fantastic how Apple has basically turned the turntables. It is fantastic how they went ahead of the game and did not stand in line and call AI AI and just slapped it on iOS 18 like AI is in iOS 18. No, they wanted to brand it their own. And by branding it to their own concept, they've created something unique. And Siri, what was the worst smart assistant, it has a huge potential of becoming the best smart assistant. And I'll tell you why. First of all, smart assistants today, they, well, are very, very limited. Artificial intelligence has everything, but it needs access. And access comes with a price. It comes with privacy. So privacy issues from ChatGPT, from all the other players in the game, you feel hazy about giving them permission to see your contacts, see your messages, see your email, see everything. Well, since Apple has promised us that they're going to be doing everything on device, and only parts of those requests are going out to their own cloud servers, it is bringing more confidence in for us. Therefore, we're going to use it more. Siri has all the information from us. It has access to our contacts, our calendars, our pictures, our messages, our email, everything. So it knows a lot about us. That's why all of these other wearable chat services have failed, because they don't know anything about you and they need to learn from scratch, and it's slow and it goes to the cloud and no. Siri knows everything right from the get-go. It works on device, so it's going to be fast. Therefore, it's going to do all the tasks very quickly, efficiently, and save you time. Because with all of these things that we're asking from these artificial intelligence beings or things, is basically to save ourselves some time. And a lot of them cannot do that. And what I've seen from the demos, what I feel from the demos, is Siri is going to save us a lot of time. The big problem with this whole thing is that not everyone's going to get it. So the implementation and the process is going to be a slow one. The upgrade process is going to be kind of like when we switched from the Intel Max to the M1 Max or the M Series Max. It's slow. It's going to take 2 to 3 to 4 years until everyone gets access to this. And the reason is because it's only available on A17 Pro chips and the M series chips, which is more MacBook and iPad, but it's only available on A17 Pro chips, which means it's only available on the iPhone 15 Pro and iPhone 15 Pro Max. And obviously now the new iPhone is coming out in September. It's going to be iPhone 16, 16 Plus, 16 Pro, 16 Pro Max is going to be available on those devices too, probably. But not a lot of people are upgrading year over year. I mean, yeah, 100 million people are going to buy iPhones, sure. But there are over 1 billion iPhones in the world, and those people are not necessarily getting their chance to use Apple Intelligence. And this is good for Apple because it's a slow process. It's the learning curve that they're going through. So they're going to start off with basically the iPhone 15 Pro and Pro Max users and all the Mac and iPad users. And from there, it's going to grow every year to more and more. They're going to improve the capacity of their servers. They're going to improve everything with their operating system and how the whole implementation works. And it's just going to develop But in my humble opinion, last week was the day when Apple changed and Apple became more of a software company than a hardware company. Yes, they create iPhones for us. They create gorgeous MacBooks for us and tablets and everything, or iPads. But the most important thing in the future is not hardware anymore. It's software and how that software impacts our lives. And based on the demos, based on everything that we've seen, this truly has the potential of impacting your life for the better. And the reason for that is because it's gonna make your life simpler. You're gonna be able to talk to Siri like it's an assistant, and it's going to help you. It doesn't help you now. It causes more problems than use at this moment in the current stage that we are at iOS 17 and previous generations. And even for users who are stuck on an iPhone 15 or iPhone 14, they're not gonna get the new Siri. They're gonna get the old Siri, the terrible Siri. All the smart home devices like the HomePods are gonna have the old Siri until Apple upgrades them. And it's gonna take a long time, but it's gonna change how you use your phone. It's gonna change how you look at your notifications, how you look at your email, how you reply to those emails, how you reply to the messages, how you summarize things. It's gonna make your life a lot more easier. You're gonna be able to focus on life more and less on your phone. And it was a very interesting thing that I saw from Marques Brownlee's interview with Tim Cook, is that Apple is proactively trying to make you put down your phone. And it's moves like this that I truly believe that Apple really wants you to use your phone less and live more, because a phone is a tool and that tool needs to be used until there's a purpose for it. It's not doom scrolling. It's connecting with others, using it for your job, creating with it, and then when you're done, put it down. And the thing that Apple Intelligence is gonna allow you to do is it's gonna save you time to put down your phone and spend more time with others.